have to make a disclaimer. It's only my opinion. Please take it with a grain of salt. Hi, everyone. This video is all about fashion fun. It's kind of like taking a walk down fashion memory lane. I've got my list here, and I think you're going to be thoroughly amused by some of the things on this list. And I'm truly sorry. I sincerely mean this if I offend anyone, because I absolutely don't mean to. So here we go with our trip down fashion memory lane. And the first on the list is sun visors. I don't know about you, but I haven't worn a sun visor. Well, I can't remember when. Remember how we wore sun visors? Perhaps sun visors originated for sport. I remember wearing them when I played tennis. Wearing a sun visor became a real trend. You could buy them in prints and colors. I remember wearing them to the beach quite often until I realized they weren't very good for sun protection. They only came out so far and they didn't cover the side of your face. Colored sunglasses. I remember having a pink pair and I just thought I was so cool in my pink sunglasses. Unfortunately, I can't actually show you any of the items on this list because I no longer own them. I can't remember the last time I owned a pair of colored sunnies, not even a white pair. Ooh, scrunchies. How 1990s were they? The naughty 90s, we loved our scrunchies, didn't we? I had such a collection of scrunchies. And once again, I don't own one anymore. Although I did find them really great for putting your hair up in a bun. Maybe I should revisit scrunchies just for the convenience factor. Sarongs, I don't know what you call them where you live. We've always called them sarongs in Australia. And everybody here, when you say a sarong, they know what that means. At proximity to Bali, the Indonesian island that so many people go to for a holiday, our proximity is quite close to Bali. Mostly due to people holidaying and visiting Bali, sarongs became a part of the culture in Australia. I used to import and sell thousands of sarongs, not only in my retail shops, but I also wholesale sarongs. And I found out pretty quickly what colours most Australians like to buy, and they were a little bit different from some other countries. Here, we pretty much stuck to our blues and greens and sometimes purple. Just because I think it's outdated and out of fashion doesn't mean that you do. You might still be using it or wearing it, and if you do and you like it, well, that's great. Dr. Scholl sandals. Who had a pair of wooden Dr. Scholl sandals? I owned a few pairs over the years, but my favorite was pink. I love my pink Dr. Scholls. How I walked in them, I don't know, because really today I wouldn't find it comfortable to walk in wood. And there were Ugg boots. Australia was rather probably a bit famous for Ugg boots because we're such a sheep wool producing country. I haven't owned a real pair of sheepskin Ugg boots, the real deal. Oh, for such a long time. And there's lots of great imitations around, but I don't see people wearing Ugg boots out and about like we used to, with their jeans tucked in or their tracky dacks, their track pants tucked in. And sticking with shoes, who remembers the kung fu shoes? That's what we used to call them. I don't know what they're called anywhere else, but we call them kung fu shoes. You used to be able to buy them in Chinatown. I remember going into Chinatown in Sydney and buying my kung fu shoes. And then, of course, all the fashion stores started selling them, and you could get embroidered ones as well. Sometimes they'd have butterflies on them or dragons on them. Mostly they were black, but you could buy colored ones. I haven't seen kung fu shoes since kung fu went out. Studded denim. Jeweled denim, embroidered denim. Remember that look, particularly with the denim jackets, but also with jeans. Just when I thought that that look was so ridiculously out, recently I was looking on the Zara website and I saw, yes, denim jackets with jewels on them and studs on them or rhinestones on them. I don't care if the denim jackets with the rhinestones are back in. I'm not going to go there. I might do studs, but no, I'm not going to go there with the jewels. Not going to do it. I'm not going to do it. The whole denim embellishment look. There were vests, there were bags, just about anything they could put on denim. Lace, crochet, embroidery. But I think the jewel ones were the big thing. Back to shoes, because I said this is no particular order. What we used to call jiffies. I don't know what you call them anywhere else. I'll put photos of jiffies up. But you wore them predominantly around the house. They were elastic all the way around, so you could just sneak your foot into them. Originally, they started out as just a slipper, I think, to wear around the house. Women started wearing them outside the house like a ballet flat. Jewels on your sunglasses. Remember when that was a trend? The big oversized sunglasses, and here on the side, Diamantes in particular were really popular here on the side of your sunglasses. More recently, I've stopped wearing rubber thongs. probably several years ago, I just stopped wearing them, and I used to wear them only to the beach. There was a phase I was wearing them out and about casually. Remember when Havaianas came in and they were so incredibly popular and you could get them in every color. In America and Canada and other countries, I know they're called flip-flops. We never call them flip-flops. We still don't call them flip-flops. To us, they'll always be a thong. And I know for the US, a thong is a G-string. It's your knickers. Yeah, it's completely different. Australian comedians really milk that. They really have fun with the difference between where you wear a thong and where we wear thongs. Well, we wear them on our feet and we need to. I don't wear any thongs anymore, not leather, not faux leather, not as a fashion garment, and I don't even wear them to the beach anymore. I think they've pretty much gone out. Frosted makeup, in particular, lipstick. I used to really like wearing frosted lipstick. And I threw my last one out recently. I hadn't worn it for a long time. I think I've looked quite dated wearing frosted lipstick now. And I'm quite cautious with the frosted eyeshadow. The companies just keep making it though. I don't know why in every palette that I buy, there's always actually more frosted than the matte. And I don't understand that because I don't think frosted is as popular as it used to be. Although I know that women are still wearing frosted eyeshadow. I understand that. I know it's not gone out of fashion. If frosted lipstick is still in fashion, let me know because I'm not aware of that because I don't wear it, but it might be still in. What about large crystal pendants or big boho pendants? I did have a few, but I gave them to the thrift stores. I found them really heavy and chunky, dangling down and getting in my way. I haven't seen those really big boho pendants around. Cork platform heels. Platform heels, but not just platforms, cork platforms. I used to absolutely love my cork platforms. I had a pair that I was in love with. They were a deep maroon color. Yes, we say maroon and Americans say maroon, but you know the color I'm talking about. I recall I was living in the city and I thought it was so cool with my Levi flares and my cork platforms. And of course my fringe bag, my suede fringe bag, and it was real suede back then. That just came to mind. The fringe suede bags and the vests and the jackets, fringing. Wow, wasn't it popular? But that was going back a bit further. I think that was more 80s. Something I haven't seen much of lately is pink hair. Women dyeing their hair or putting colored pink into their hair. I haven't seen that happening so much. Remember when the mauve and the pink was really popular? I quite like it. I think it's really pretty. I was watching a fashion show recently, a styling fashion show, and there was a younger woman, quite young, and she did have her hair dyed pink, but it was really quite different. More like streaking, it wasn't the all over pink look. And that's the first time I've seen it in a long time. Maybe it's come back in and I'm not aware of that. This is more recent, it's fedora hats. I owned a big collection of fedora hats. I really got into the fedora hats and I was wearing them in the early 2000s and probably for a whole decade I was wearing fedoras until I realized they didn't really give me very good sun protection. So I ditched the fedora hats and moved over to a wider brim hat, which makes a lot more sense. It was so popular with the guys and the girls. I saw lots of guys wearing fedoras. Don't think I'm seeing fedoras out and about so much now or at all. And crocheted vests. Yeah, they're probably more of a bit of a hippie look, but I remembered that we even had the crocheted vests made from the patchwork, which I call the Afghan squares, where they join them all together. Oh, that could look like you're wearing the rug off your bed. I used to crochet a lot, and I did those Afghan squares where you join them together, and I made rugs. Can't imagine wearing one of those crocheted vests today. I have more on the list, but the video would be too long. Thank you for watching, everyone. Bye-bye now.